Hi, hello, welcome to Homeschool. This is your class 10 Mathematics NCERT or CBSC board. We are in our chapter 15, Surface Areas and Volumes, exercise 15.2, 7th problem. A solid consisting of a right circular cone. Is it a right circular cone? Yes. Of height 120 centimeters. What is the height of this cone? 120 centimeter. And radius 60 centimeters. Let me draw the figure here. Height of the cone is equal to 120 centimeters. And radius of the cone is 60 centimeters. Standing on a hemisphere. Where is this cone standing? Standing on a hemisphere of radius 60 centimeters. You can see a hemisphere. Radius of this is 60 centimeters. Is placed upright in a right circular cylinder. What is this? This cone is placed on a hemisphere. Then, hemisphere of radius 60 centimeters is placed upright in the sense like this, upright in a right circular cylinder full of water such that it touches the bottom. Find the volume of water left in the cylinder. If the radius of the cylinder is 60 centimeters and its height is 180 centimeters. Let us draw a cylinder here. Okay, this cylinder is fully filled with water. Imagine this cylinder is filled with water. Okay, now this solid is placed upright in a right circular cylinder. So what happens? You can see this. This is the hemispherical part and this is the cone part. It is placed inside the vessel. This solid is placed inside the cylinder. Then what happens? Same as the before session, what we have done, marble problem. What will happen here? The water comes out. How much amount of water comes out? What is the volume of this solid? That much amount of water will be coming out. Now, we need to find the volume of water. Volume of water left in the cylinder. Water which came out, we don't consider. How much amount of water left in the cylinder? How can we find this, children? Let us understand this problem here. Look here carefully. I have taken a cylinder. Fully filled with water. You can see water in this. In another hand, I am going to take a cone which is mounted on a hemisphere. The right circular cone and hemisphere, this solid is inverted right upright in a right circular cylinder. What happened? What happened here? The water came outside. Right? So, the amount of water which is left in the cylinder is your problem. How can we calculate this? Volume of a cylinder minus volume of the solid. What is the solid here? Hemisphere and cone. See how much amount of water is left. So, if this is placed, now no water will come out. Means this much volume of water already came outside. If you want to check it out, please check it out. Is water coming out? No. Already this much volume of water came outside. Actually, this is not a perfect cylinder for this figure. The solid completely covers in the cylinder. So, frame the formula. Volume of water left in the cylinder is equal to volume of a cylinder minus volume of solid. Solid means again we need to consider the volume of two solids. that is volume of a right circular cone plus volume of hemisphere. Let's start our solution. Given radius of cone, R is equal to right circular cone height 120 and radius 60 centimeters. Radius is 60 centimeters and height of the cone, H is equal to 120 centimeters. And next, hemisphere radius 60 centimeters. Radius of hemisphere 60 centimeters. So we are talking about here three solids. We can take here R1, radius of a cone, and height of a cone H1. Radius of hemisphere R2 if you want you can take, or radius is same with the cone, if you want you can take R1 also. And your next solid is cylinder. Radius of cylinder. What is the radius of right circular cylinder? Observe here where you can see. Radius of the cylinder is 60 centimeters. And this is your third solid. Mark it as R3. Radius R3 is equal to 60 centimeters. And next, height of the cylinder is 180 centimeters. H1 completed. And this is the third figure, so I write H3. H2 not there. Hemisphere, we don't talk about height. So, I write here H3. I don't write with H2. If you want, you can write, but you will be confused. H1, H3, I'll take. Third solid, second solid, first solid. You can easily identify. Anyway, you can mark, children. Frame the formula. Volume of water left in the cylinder. Volume of water left in the cylinder is the question we need to solve. That will be equal to volume of cylinder, minus volume of solid. This complete, we call it as a solid. In this total volume of cylinder, if you remove volume of this solid, you can get the water remained in the cylinder. Let's write the formula. Volume of cylinder, pi r square h. And this is cylinders. What is the number we have given? R3 H3. Write that. Pi R3 square H3 minus. When we talk about volume of a solid, please remember, volume of a solid means we need to write volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. Volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. Volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere, that equal to pi R3 square H3 minus volume of a cone. Cone, what is the number we have given? 1. Volume of a cone, it will be 1 by 3 pi r square h. And cone we have given 1. So, pi r1 square h1 plus volume of a hemisphere formula. 2 by 3 pi r cube. And this solid we have given as r2. Right? Now, you can remove this from the bracket. Okay, let's write the value here. R3, 60 whole square into H3, 180 minus 1 by 3 pi R1 square means 60 whole square into H1. H1 value is 120 minus into plus, it will be minus 2 by 3 pi R2 value is 60 whole cube. Okay, now observe in these three. Is there anything common? Yes. Pi 60 square is common. Substitute pi value 22 by 7 into 60 into 60. Okay, this is common in all these three. Other than 60, what do you have? 60 and pi? 180 minus pi 60 square. Take out common. 120 by 3. Better you can cancel and say it is minus 40. And here also 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 into 260s. If you take out common, 160 is left here. And this one cancel, 320s. Now, that equal to 22 into, is it cancelling? No, it won't cancel. 60s, 3600. 3600 into 22, multiply children. 3600 into 22. That will be 7200297. That will be 79,200 by 7 into 180 minus 40. 22 is 40. Minus 40 will be minus 80. 180 minus 80. 180 minus 80, it will be how much? 100. Okay. 79,200 by 7 into 180 minus 80 will be 100. Multiply this 100 for this. 79,200 and 00. If you multiply by 7. Cancel this one. 7 ones are 7, 7 ones are 7, 7 ones are 7, 22. 7 threes are 21 and 10 is left. Again, 7 ones are 7, 30. 7 fours are 28. Again, 20. 7 twos are 14. 6 left, 60. Then it will be 8.57 you are going to get. So what is your answer here? 113142 8.57 is your answer. So therefore, if you divide, you are going to get this as an answer. 113142 8.57. Therefore, volume of water. Therefore, volume of water left in cylinder is equal to 11,31,428.57. What's the unit here? Unit is centimeter, so centimeter cube. Always volume will be in cubic units, therefore this is centimeter cube. See here, the cylinder full of water such that the solid, it means solid, touches the bottom of the cylinder. Then solid height and cylinder height will be equal. Okay, is this clear, this problem? See, this is the answer we got here. Let us convert this into meters. Do you know children have to convert this? 1 meter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Then what is 1 centimeter is equal to? Send this side. That will be 1 by 100 meters. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meters. But I am talking here about cubic centimeters. Cubic centimeters, if I talk, 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter whole cube. Right? So now it will be 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 multiply 3 times. It will be 10 lakh. Right? 10 lakh meter cube. Instead of converting 1 centimeter cube, we need to divide with 10 lakh. Then it will be converted into meter cube. So this centimeter cube convert into meter cube. That means you need to divide with 10 lakh. That is equal to 11,31,428.57 by 10 lakh meter cube. If you divide with this, you can change the centimeter cube into meter cube. Now shift this decimal point. Count how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from this decimal point, count 6 digits and shift the decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That will be 1.131428.57 meter cube. Therefore, final answer, volume of water left in the cylinder is equal to 1.13, you can write it as approximately 1.13 meter cube is your final answer. So, once again, understand the figure carefully. There is a solid which is made up of a cone mounted on a hemisphere, and you are going to take a cylinder which is fully filled with water. When the solid means hemisphere and cone, combinedly if it is inverted in a cylinder which is fully filled with water, then some amount of water comes out. How much amount of water comes out? What is the volume of the solid you have inverted in the cylinder? That much amount of water will be coming out. So, we need to find the remaining water. What the water came out? No need. What is the water left in the cylinder? How can we calculate? In volume of cylinder, you need to subtract the volume of solid. That is, volume of hemisphere plus volume of cone is to be subtracted from volume of cylinder. Let's see the last problem of this exercise. That is your problem number 8. A spherical glass vessel has a cylindrical neck, 8 centimeters long, 2 centimeters in diameter. So observe here, children, cylindrical neck. I was showing only neck. It is in which shape? Cylindrical shape. Having its neck height is 8 centimeters and its diameter is 2. Diameter 2 centimeters means radius is equal to 1 centimeter. Let's write here. Radius is 1 centimeter, height of the cylinder is 8 centimeter. The diameter of the spherical part, observe here, this is in which shape? Sphere, right? This is a spherical glass vessel, has a cylindrical neck. Imagine this figure as a spherical glass vessel having cylindrical neck. Look here carefully. Spherical, cylindrical neck. We have seen the height and radius of this cylindrical neck. We are going to talk about this sphere. That is spherical part. Diameter is 8.5 centimeters. Radius will be 8.5 by 2 centimeters. By measuring the amount of water it holds, a child finds its volume to be 345 centimeter cube. So, what does a child do? This spherical glass vessel, which is having a cylindrical neck, a child, she has measured the amount of water it can be stored in this vessel. And she said that it is 345 centimeter cube. Volume of this vessel is 345 centimeter cube. Check whether she is correct. Is she correct? What the answer she got, volume, is it correct or not? We need to check it out. Taking the above as the inside measurements. This measurements, we are going to consider it as the inside measurements. And we are going to calculate the volume of the vessel. And check the answer. If your answer is 345 centimeter cube, then what the child said answer is correct. If it is not same, you say that child, what she said is wrong. Right, let's start our solution. When a spherical glass vessel has a cylindrical neck. You can see the picture here. A spherical glass vessel having a cylindrical neck. Diameter of spherical shaped vessel. What is the diameter of this? 8.5. Radius is 8.5 by 2. Diameter D is equal to 8.5 centimeters. And radius R1 is equal to 8.5 by 2. 4.25. Better you can stop here itself. I write here 8.5 by 2 centimeters only. I don't want to cancel. Next, height of the cylindrical neck. Height of the cylindrical neck H is equal to 8 centimeters. Diameter of cylinder. This is another diameter. Diameter of cylinder is how much? 2 centimeters. But radius. Here you have an R1, right? Let me take here R2. Is 2 by 2. That will be 1 centimeters. Radius of cylindrical neck is equal to 1 centimeter. Height 8 centimeters. And radius of spherical part is 8.5 by 2. Volume of vessel. We need to find out the volume of the vessel. That means volume of a sphere plus volume of cylinder. That will be volume of sphere plus volume of cylinder. Volume of sphere formula, 4 by 3 pi r cube. Volume of sphere, 4 by 3 pi r cube plus volume of cylinder, pi r square h. Pi r square h. Observe here carefully. We have taken sphere as R1 and cylindrical part as 2. Let us write here this one R1, this is R2. Both the radius are different. So compulsory you need to differentiate with R1 and R2. Is there anything common? Yes, pi is common. Take out common. Pi into 4 by 3. R1 value is 8.5 by 2 into 8.5 by 2 into 8.5 by 2. 3 times cube, no? So I'll multiply 3 times here. Plus pi, take out common. R2 value. R2 value is 1. 1 into height h. Okay. Now this one, 2 2s are 4, this 2 1s and this is 1, cancels. And now 3 2s are 6 and numerator you are going to multiply now. Numerator multiply here, 8.5 into 8.5. That will be 5 5s are 25, 8 5s are 40, 42. 8 5s are 40, 8 8s are 64, 68. And that will be 527225. You need to put decimal point after 2 digits. That is 72.25. If we multiply 8.5 into 8.5, we get 72.25. Again, you multiply for this one more 8.5. Let's do the calculation part here. 72.25 into 8.5. 5 5's are 25, 5 2's are 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 5 2's are 10, 11, 5 7's are 35, 36. Okay, so now next one, 8. 8 5's are 40, 8 2's are 16, 16 plus 4, 20, 8 2's are 16, 16 plus 2, 18. 8 7s are 56 plus 1, 57. Now add this 5, 2, 1, 14, 11, 6. Put the decimal where you need to keep. Here one decimal and here two. That means 1 plus 2, 3. After 3 digits, put a decimal point. 614.125. Okay, let's write here. Let's carry our problem here. That equal to pi into 614.125 divided by 3 into 2. 6 plus 1 into 8 will be 8. Now cancel this one. 6 ones are 6. And now 1. You cannot do any cancellation. So put 0 here. Then 14. 14 means 6 twos are 12. 2 left. So you need to take 1. That means 21. Put a point here. 6 table. 6 threes are 18. Then 3 left 32. 6 fives are 30. And now 2 left. That will be 25. 6 fours are 24. It continues. You can stop there. That will be add these 8 pi into 102.354 plus 8. Add these two. 8, 9, 10. That will be 110.354. Pi value. We did not substitute pi value, right? So substitute now pi value here. Substitute pi value 3.14. Now do multiplication these two. Let me do rough here. 110354 into 314. That will be multiply this. 4 fours are 16. 21. 4 threes are 12. 14. 4 ones are 4. 4. And again with 1 if you multiply. 4, 5, 3, 0, 1, 1. And again if you multiply with 3. 3 fours are 12. 5 3 is 15, 16. 3 threes are 9, 10. 3 ones are 3, 3. And now if you add 6, 5, 11. 11, 5, 6, 4, 3. And put decimal point 110.354 you have multiplied. So 3.14 you have here. 2 digits and here 3 digits, completely 5 digits. Count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Therefore, your final answer is equal to 346.51156. Right? Therefore, this one we can approximate to, still it may extend 346.512 centimeter. Cube. You can end your problem here, children. 346.512 centimeter cube. Therefore, finally, what is this problem here? Therefore, the volume of vessel is equal to 346.51 centimeter cube. Now, there is one tiny question in this problem. A child measured and said it is 345 centimeter cube. Is it 345? No, it is 346.5. Is child correct? No, child is. No, what the child said is not correct. No, child calculation. Child calculation of volume of the vessel is wrong. Child calculation is wrong. Therefore, your answer is 346.51 centimeter cube. 51 or approximate to 52. So you can write there. Okay. With this, we are going to end our session. In our next session, we are going to continue with the next exercise. Until then, keep watching. Thank you all.